Hello and welcome to the Midyear nominees for the 2024 Shamsys Award for Excellence in Divulging of Information through Syntax Comprehended by Many. I'm Samer Khalaf. With me we have Patrick Redford and Giddy Nathan. If you've never watched this before, we're going to break down examples of syntax that we've found in sports journalism and other parts of journalism, and analyze what makes them so incomprehensible or unique, or they have a lot of different elements to them.
Yeah, and if you're new to the English language, this is sort of like a how-to guide. Like if you write and talk like these people, you too can get a job mostly at the Athletic, kind of saying whatever you want.
Yeah, I feel like it was a particularly strong crop. I don't know if it's like an election year, so like really weird scoopies is just kind of in the air, but definitely a good set of candidates here, and it's not even the full field, which we'll consider at the end of the year. So keep an eye out for infrastructure words. It's always a big part of these, ramps, paths, walkways, things of that nature,
Yeah, when
bridges.
various things span each other in metaphorically complex ways, that's the shit we're into.
I think as it's developed, we just see more examples in the wild, or other people are more attuned to them. So this year, for just like the mid-year check-in, we had enough examples that we would normally have in just like a full year, so we had to trim some down. But I think we do have a good range of examples and attempts at the English language here. So we'll start with the first one. There we go. So we have, of course, we have to start with Shams. There's currently a growing disconnect between Darvin Ham and Lakers locker room, stemming from disjointedness around rotation and adjustments. This is kind of like a good SAT example of what you're going to see for the rest of the stream, in which something can be described in one word, but instead takes up like seven or eight.
Yeah,
Yeah.
the stemming from disjointedness is really good.
Well, it's a disconnect stemming from
Yeah,
disjointedness. It's a growing disconnect.
one wonders if you could just say there is a disconnect, like
Yeah. That would be it. I mean, the thing is, if you were like diagramming sentence or like trying to find the source of this, yeah, it would, disjointedness would be the source, and then disconnect would be
yeah.
growing out of it,
And if we're
I
trying to think
guess.
literally, perhaps this like disjointed, like think about like a shoulder or something, and then the stem is like the arm extending from the shoulder, but it's
Yeah.
like because of that disjointedness, there's like if you're going for a handshake or something, there's like a disconnect on the other end.
It's like a Google Maps glitch of an illusion.
Like you could just replace the word stemming from disjointedness around with over, and then this
Yeah,
becomes a
exactly.
totally
Over
legible
rotation and
sentence.
adjustments. Yeah.
Yeah. It would be very easy to fix.
I also, something else that I just noticed now for the first time is that losers of three in a row is written with the numeral, which is not AP style. And then nine of 12 is written with the word nine written out, which is AP style. So it's like that's like just a sort of second order perversion, but like this is why the award's named after him. I think betting markets have him as sort of like, he's a heavy favorite again this year, but obviously, like, the person who won
Well,
last year has put some pretty strong entries down recently.
I mean,
So
always amazing to see nytimes.com at the bottom of something like this, which is going to be a new phenomenon this year, I think, because they like the I don't think the URLs were like this last year on the Athletic. I think that's a name.
Okay. Well, we'll go to the next one. One of you can read this.
Golden State's Draymond Green, on an indefinite league suspension since December 13th, is expected to return to the Warriors facility in the coming days to start ramping up to resume play again. Sources tell ESPN. So, this is just a classic. The reason it's here is because of the ramps, and all that surrounds the ramps. In this case, he's okay. Well, actually, let me walk through
There's like at least three expectant
it.
things to this.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, so play is there. Then there's ramping up to resume play. And then that's in the coming days. But that's only, he's expected to return in the coming days. So there's like three layers of hedging, I guess, as to
Yeah.
when he's going to play.
Yeah, and is ramping up to resume play, like the verb resume there sort of like makes me jolt. I don't think it's
Yeah.
correct, right?
Ramping
There's
up to
something going.
Resume play.
resumption of play would somehow sound worse, but maybe it would be more
I
technically
think
correct.
r ramping up to resume playing, I think you would say,
Yeah.
right? Or to resume.
Yeah.
Well, I guess.
I guess he could just like resume play, like you would
Play. You could
resume
resume
playing the
play.
game, but
Yeah.
there
Also,
is
ramping
something
up to
off.
resume play.
It's just like a lot of like from to start ramping up. To resume play, you have like three different kinds of verbs in that, I think.
To start ramping up to resume.
Oh
Well, I
no, just
guess
two. Well, you got two infinitives and then
two
one gerund.
infinitives. Yeah, to start ramping up to resume
I
play.
think basically this starts with, because it's in the Scoopster classic past tense, they just is expected to. That makes everything after like more
Yeah.
repeating. Like you're building a ramp on like shaky foundations.
I assume you were also, it was just like the purpose of this tweet is just because Draymond was indefinitely suspended, so Woj just wants to be the first to be like, oh yeah, he's coming back at some
He's
point.
coming back soon. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, the tweet could be is expected to resume play soon.
Yeah, that
So,
would make
yeah.
way more sense.
I was just like expected to return to the Warriors facility, yeah, to resume play.
Yeah, to sort of get to like the thesis of why this is worth making fun of is like this is so overstuffed with words to convey such a small thing, but it's like because he's mostly communicating like the posture of knowledge, like the sort of wised up like sourcedness rather than actually communicating anything that is itself important, you like have to put all these weird dependent clauses and like superfluous
Yeah.
words, and like it's like the form demands this structure, which is perfect.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, let's go to the next one.
All right, I can do this one.
There we go.
Oh, all right, this is our winner from last year. This is January 8th, so she started the year very strong. League source to me just now on whether they feel hashtag Titans head coach Mike Vrabel continues with the organization amid questions about whether everyone's on the same page in the direction of the future. They just said, in their opinion, I'd call it 50-50 right now. I mean, she's the winner for a reason. This is
Yeah, there's nothing in
there's so much to like.
it.
The league source to me just now on really good is really good.
Yeah.
Especially because the thing that comes after that is like not short or like clear.
Yeah.
Yeah, usually that's like a lead into some breaking news or something, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And like this is almost totally backwards. Like I think if you just started with I'd call it 50-50 right now and then like dash like league source to me, you don't need any of that middle part, but that's what makes it so good is the
The
amid
lead up.
questions about whether everyone's on the same
Yeah.
page is bad, and the direction of the future, and they just said in their opinion without commas. I mean, this is someone whose use of commas sort of won her the award last year, so it's like
Right.
it's
Yeah.
interesting to see her playing with the form.
It is three lines of lead up for half a line of quote.
I have no idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really want to know the nature of the source. Like, is it his agent? Is it somebody in the Titans? Like, or is it just somebody in the NFL who she asked whether Mike Vrabel would get fired or not, and they just gave their opinion?
Also, direction of the future is pretty
Yeah,
vague.
that's a great
Yeah,
phrase.
that's good.
Like this sort of this posits a perhaps bidirectional flow of time, you know?
That's kind of her
Yeah.
thing.
A very Christopher Nolan-esque view
Yeah.
of that's another recurring theme is that Scoopsters typically use language that you would find as plot devices in Christopher Nolan movies.
Yeah, exactly. This is some tetrapod ass
Yeah.
phrasing here.
Yeah. They love the movie Tenet. But next one.
I'll do this one.
Okay.
Julius Randle will go through rehab process during 2 to 3 week period, NYK referenced in statement. At some point, Randle and NYK will decide on next steps. It's premature to say anything's been decided or ruled out at this point. People familiar with WAF matters and wait and see situation.
It's very thematically similar to the Justina tweet.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is good because the each sentence like basically
undermines like
yeah.
Yeah, like each one makes sense on its own, but then taken together, it's like this is a profoundly compelling document that argues against its own existence.
Yeah. He's like, it's premature to say anything besides like you're the only one saying anything.
Also, like the very act of deciding is like ruling some stuff out. Like,
yeah,
that's
yeah.
true.
You're ruling out all the stuff you didn't decide on doing stuff.
I like that. Actually, I'm thinking about it now. Each sentence gets increasingly uncertain. So the first
yeah.
is like, this will happen. The second one,
yeah.
at some point, they will decide what happens next. And then it's like, it's we can't say anything. And then after that, it's like,
no one has any idea.
Yeah, let's see
not
what we
anyone
figure
saying
out.
anything. Yeah.
We'll see what happens. Wait and see.
This actually would become a perfect tweet if there was a fifth sentence that just said, this tweet has been deleted. And it was just
Yeah.
like,
Yeah.
it just would be like a nice Dadaist Shamsy.
Yeah, but it's kind of a an odd one from a reporter that I actually find very clear and good on the Knicks. So everyone has their days.
Maybe it was just like Knicks fans are hectoring him so much for Julius
He
Randle
just had to
update.
give
They
him
just like,
something,
I'll
yeah.
throw them whatever I have and then just hedge it so I don't have to issue a correction. I don't even know how you would correct this. There's nothing to correct because there's nothing that it's conveying. So,
Yeah.
all right, I'll
It's
go
like
next.
if they never decide on next steps, or yeah, that's like there's nothing certain in here. It's perfect.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, here's a good one. I'll do this one. It's Mark Stein. The Mavericks are in the process of trying to acquire the needed draft compensation to furnish Washington to complete its pending deal to acquire Wizards center Daniel Gafford for Richaun. League sources say. Because this one, like when I was originally going through the doc, I was like, this isn't that interesting. And then you like really look into what he's trying to say, and I still don't understand. Well, why
Yeah,
they would
okay.
use that many imperatives?
If you
Trying
just
to acquire, to furnish, to complete, to acquire.
Yeah, there's
It's
four
the to
infinitives
furnish
there.
Washington bit that's like really
That's really
annoying, by
funny.
Yeah. It's like an extra, I mean, it's an extra like three steps, but in this case, even if you're familiar with Scoopstories, you're just like, that's an extra half step you didn't need at all.
Yeah,
You
it's
just
like
say like the Mavericks need more draft picks if they want to complete their deal for
yeah,
Daniel Gafford,
that's it.
for Richaun Holmes.
And
Yeah.
just furnish as a verb without like any other words behind it, especially like in this context, is super weird.
I love to furnish Washington with needed draft compensation.
But I hate when I don't when I have to go through the process to acquire it.
Exactly. The biggest hurdle in today's NBA.
All right, let's go to the next one.
This one is, it's, I, we had to include it because it's not really like standard scoop series. Obviously, it's from Mayor Muriel Bowser, but it's just so good in how useless it
Oh,
is as a
this
statement.
kind of reminds me of that Chuck Grassley, I think it's Chuck Grassley tweet about something that was both a dollar and a pound bargain.
Oh, Newt Gingrich,
New
the
Gingrich, yeah.
McChicken.
WMATA is America's metro system for sure, and DC's metro system especially. I mean, that's facts.
Yeah. I'm looking up the Newt Gingrich McChicken. It's like a McDonald's tweet.
Yeah.
McDonald's grilled chicken McWrap at 250 calories is both a dollar and pound bargain.
That's just good writing.
I don't even, I wish
I
I
don't
had
even really
looked
know what
more.
it means.
Yeah. I wish I had looked more into the context of this. Like maybe people were angry that DC Metro sucked or something, or like maybe a Republican criticized WMATA. I don't know. But I just really like the syntax of this sentence. Because
In
I even,
DC.
When I looked at the tweet, all the replies were like, "What the hell does this mean?" Like, anyway, that's
Maybe this has something to do with the duality of DC being both a city in the United States and like the cap, like the representative of the country.
That's how I kind of read it, yeah.
the McKenna paradox.
Yeah.
Okay. There's another Justina one.
Oh, this one's good.
Wait, was
You
this one of the ones that got edited?
No.
Okay. I
No,
don't
it
think
wasn't.
so.
So. But this one has, I can do this one, but
Yeah, you do
it's
it.
just the second part is really good to me. I'm told the
Yeah.
Giants and running back Saquon Barkley's representatives had a good initial meeting on Wednesday at the scouting combine, per source. My understanding is the team remains open to multiple options, including memorializing Barkley's legacy as a New York Giant, pending an agreement on mutual terms. This
Okay,
makes it
for
sound like he
he's
died.
dead. Yeah,
Yeah, he came.
for one, it sounds like he's dead. For two, like I don't think the big hang up in these negotiations is like whether they're going to memorialize his legacy or not. I doubt that was a major factor in the conversation.
Also, I just like again with there's all these little things in here. Agreement on mutual terms is totally redundant.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like
So
the
yeah,
first,
agreement is mutual.
yeah, the first part implies the second.
Yeah. And just for people who don't follow football, Saquon Barkley did not sign with the Giants. I
They
think he,
memorialize his legacy
yeah.
as a giant?
Yeah, his legacy was not memorialized. He went to the
Yeah.
Eagles, I'm pretty sure.
Was he buried in state in a Giants jersey or
Yes,
not? Is the question that I'm
the
wondering
tomb
here.
of the unknown running back. That's where he is.
Yeah,
I think also the other thing I want to note is good parentheses initial meeting. I don't know if we need to qualify that
I with
necessarily.
her, I feel like it's like this is very like pointedly a copy and paste from a text from an agent or something in a
Yeah.
way that is supposed to indicate to you that she is like in contact. It's like I am quoting, and even
Right.
if there's like no, even if you're just quoting good meeting or good initial meeting, it's like the point is the quotes, right?
Yeah. Okay, we'll get a next one. We'll have more Josina to come too, so there'll be
Yeah, don't
plenty to
worry.
break down. This one is from a Sam Costantino. It's like a
Draft
NHL
guide?
draft preview. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So just
I can
use Phil
go.
Son McDonald's. Yeah, you can do
Some
that.
of his identity as an underaged player has been forgotten and replaced by noticing his super slick hands. Some of his identity as an underage player has been forgotten and replaced by noticing his super slick hands and creativity. His continuous his growth hasn't impacted his ability to handle the puck with pace. Okay.
So he's just older
Interesting.
now, basically.
Yeah. I like this is another I catch myself doing this sometimes, where you write a sentence and then you kind of just write the same thing again. Like you're not advancing it, you're just rephrasing it. And then
Yeah.
almost always I cut the first one because the second one makes more sense. And Sam Constantino should have just done that.
It's pretty much, it's yeah, first pancake mentality.
I like the idea, like identity as an underage player, like you're an underage American, or I guess in this case, underage Canadian. But yeah, it's pretty much just saying he got older and he has slick hands and is creative now.
Well, also, yeah, like has been forgotten by whom exactly? By him?
Replaced by
By
noticing is wild, yeah.
yeah, replaced by noticing
Forgotten
is
and replaced by noticing.
yeah.
His identity has been replaced by noticing. I hate when that happens.
Yeah. Also, classic use of impacted, in which you don't really need impacted as a.
Yeah.
You could just say like affected. It's clearer. But anyway, next one. There's another hockey one.
Is there
Derek
a hockey
Grady.
Shams?
I think I asked Barry and Lauren this once, but they
Is
didn't really
Friedman
have
the
like a.
closest to it?
I think he's like remarkably curt with his
Comp.
like tweets. Like
Okay.
he just like puts a contract details and like that kind of stuff. And he doesn't really like over
So he should be
like
praised.
flourishes. Yeah.
Yeah.
But this guy, Darren Drieger. Toronto is focused on finding the right fit. However, there is a want to act quickly. Work is underway and hiring keeps replacement. Treliving isn't making a rushed hire, but he won't wait around either. What this means is literally nothing, basically.
Yeah. He's just creating and then filling a Goldilocks zone.
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, like this kind of stuff, like this, and like the Woj thing, and there'll be other examples. It is just to like reestablish the validity of your existence as like
Yeah.
a scoopster. Just keep people informed, even when you don't have anything to keep them informed, because they just keep like tweeting at you or bothering you, or you just like don't want to get beat out by other people.
Yeah.
Okay. Should we do the next one?
Yeah, let's do
Yeah.
it.
Okay. This is
You do this one, Giri.
this is
Just
Giddy coded.
this is from CNN, I remember. I think they both had that. I
Yeah.
think they had it as a chyron as well, like on the TV screen, but
Yeah.
I believe this screenshot is from the website. New 5:10 p.m. Eastern Time. Trump has a frowned expression on his face as the verdict reading is completed. He is not moving.
Frowned expression is so good.
Yeah, has a frown expression on his
Is
face.
not moving.
Yeah. It's
What
just you imagine the Saddam Hussein
the?
like secret base
Yeah.
diagram. It's just Donald Trump prone but with a frowned expression on his face.
Weren't there like a bunch of I remember because there weren't video cameras allowed in there, so like Times
Yeah.
reporters, I remember also trying to do like
Yeah.
very like
Yeah.
grave, rich visual language, and it
They
was
said he was sitting
ridiculous.
slumped, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, sitting slow. Because that was
Or sitting
another thing.
slack. Yeah.
Yeah, there's another thing that like people kept saying he was like possibly falling asleep during the trial. And so because there were no cameras, you had to kind of describe what an old man falling asleep would look like without actually like getting into defamation of saying that he was sleeping. Like you could only describe what he might look like if he was possibly exhausted or tired.
This is like the last two-thirds of like an Elden Ring item description, where it's in
Yeah.
like kind of vaguely translated sounding like runic English with like a very ominous last sentence that's supposed to leave you with this like feeling of depth. I think it's my favorite so far.
It's a really good one.
Yeah, it's great.
Okay, we'll go to the next one.
All right, I can
Oh,
do
this is
this
a good
one.
one. Yeah.
He's put together a pretty good candidacy this year.
You put together the blog on this one too, right?
As swept away as Hurley became by the Lakers' courtship and vision for him, he ultimately couldn't walk away from a chance to make history and pursue a third straight NCAA title. Even before Lakers talks, Hurley already had a UConn offer to become one of the highest paid NCAA coaches, and those talks will continue, per sources.
The swept away, walk away one too is just the part I love about this. He got swept away, but not so swept away that he couldn't walk away.
He ultimately chose to stay home and be a family man.
It's also just
Yeah.
funny to phrase it as swept away as Hurley became.
Yeah, you can't really be
I have
degrees of
become
swept
swept
away.
away.
There's no degrees. There's no 75% swept away. Also, he was swept away by courtship and vision. So.
Okay, to just to
Oh, that's
backtrack
good.
for a minute, Sean has provided the exact New York Times quote, which was, "Trump is unresponsive, sitting slack at the defense
Sitting
table, sitting slack."
slack.
That's like written in like, "This dog won't eat his food. What's up here?"
Yeah. The shelter update at the end of the all right, do you have any more Dan Hurley takes?
No,
Just
this is just such
what's
a dumb story.
Yeah, what's been
yeah,
in the what
stupid
I blogged
story.
about how this was like, if not clearly an op, then like Hurley definitely played everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, go to defector.com and Google
Smash
Dan
that follow
Hurley for
button.
more. You can see the whole saga.
Yeah, like that smash button. All right.
Oh, this
Oh,
one is good. Minnesota Timberwolves center Rudy Gobert, personal reasons, is out for game two versus Nuggets. Gobert had birth of his first child.
It's so good. What I like about him is that he doesn't need, like, Stein will always use like 50 words where five will do, but Shams can accomplish the same amount of stupidity in like a really small box.
Yeah, very condensed
Had birth of
complication.
his first child.
Because he says personal reasons, and he just says he doesn't need personal reasons at that point. You're explaining why he's out in
Right.
the most tortured way possible, but you're still explaining it.
It's like the reasons are personal, and here they are.
Yeah,
I
he's just unveiling them.
really enjoy Gobert had birth.
Yeah,
he's like, I can't say gave birth. I'll just say had birth instead. That'll be more normal and
trying
understandable to everybody.
to think of other verbs he could have used there. Like, experienced would have been funny. Like, if
Yeah,
you
experience birth, attended birth,
attended attention.
observed birth of his first child. Okay, next one.
Okay.
Oh, wait, this one was supposed to be the end. Damn.
Should we just go forward and then come back to this?
Yeah, we'll go forward and come
I think this is
back.
a good finisher. Okay, I can
Yeah.
do this one.
Justina will be the closer, so everybody knows, but this is a different
This
thing. You
is,
can
I think
read this
this
one.
is honestly one of the big contenders.
Yeah, this is a good one.
When pundits and internet rumors flooded the zone for weeks with claims that Johnson, 37, was the overwhelming favorite, if not a lock hire in Washington, a downside of Harris running a largely leak-free search, minimal pushback occurred. Crazy ass sentence. The gleefully
Minimalist.
ignorant voices were unaware or chose not to care that the consummation of some of gossip rather than factual information. Another main view centered on reports that Johnson's camp brought with them hefty compensation demands for the second-year coordinator who schemed Detroit's offense into the elite category. League sources putting their chips in this bucket cite the agent, Richmond Flowers, as hoping to avoid Johnson's head coaching apprehension with a godfather offer he couldn't refuse.
Oh my God.
He is considered a coach who prefers holing up in his office, coming up with game plans, and playing with mad scientist vibes rather than leading a locker room. Imagine like, just like imagine like an old-timey crusty journalism professor clicking an NY Times link and seeing this slop. Like, this is not
Because
okay.
computer, like that scene of Spider-Man where Green Goblin blows through the side of Aunt May's bedroom. It's just like, what happened? That would be what happened to any journalism professor who clicked on this.
We should all pick a favorite phrase here because there's so much to like.
I love mad scientist vibes because it feels like something I would hear from a comedian at Union Hall say, ironically.
He's playing with mad scientist vibes.
Yeah.
I like consummation assumptions.
Consummations.
I like putting chips in the bucket. In the
Yeah.
bucket. What is
Consummation
that?
Assumptions could be like a 2005 conscious hip hop album.
The chips in the bucket thing is so unnecessary because it's basically
Yeah.
saying league sources who think this way. It's like you found the most insane possible way to phrase that.
Is that like a real expression? Because it would be like chips on the table is one. Is it just somebody who never played poker but thought of something similar?
Yeah, and what scenario do you put chips in a bucket?
I can't think of a one. Yeah. Also, avoiding someone's apprehension with a with an offer he couldn't
With the
refuse.
Godfather offer he couldn't refuse, which is like you're gonna use that metaphor and then be redundant about it, is so good.
Yeah, exactly. Because it's like, okay, yeah, if you trust your reader enough to use Godfather offer, then you just end it there. Or you just say an offer you couldn't refuse and be like, all right, well, they'll understand that. But then you just have to use both in case that feels like a bad editing thing too, where maybe the editor was just like, oh, what about people who haven't seen The Godfather? And it's like, well, at that point, just like change the sentence.
The first paragraph, like the substance of that first paragraph, is like so banal. It's basically just saying there are internet rumors that were wrong, but they're writing it like a Final Fantasy boss or something.
I guess the context we should have given at the top is this is about Ben Johnson, who is the offensive coordinator for the Detroit Lions and was like courted to be a head coach,
Right.
possibly for the Washington Commanders. And there was like a lot of speculation around it. I think he did an interview too, but ultimately he decided to stay in Detroit.
Yeah, those confirmation assumptions came from an echo chamber of gossip rather than factual information.
Yeah, it's like the other thing that throws me is like in the second paragraph, another main view centered on reports that Johnson's camp brought with them hefty compensation demands for the second year it makes it seem like the second year coordinator is someone else besides Johnson, like someone he wants to bring in.
Steam Detroit's offense into the elite category is
That's also
really good
that
too.
too. That's really good.
It's every clause of this is very rich. And yeah, the first paragraph is kind of somewhere in the halfway point between Final Fantasy boss and Glenn Greenwald. Like the gleefully ignorant voices were unaware or chose not to care.
There's a very distinct Greenwaldian tone to it, for sure. I don't think he could come up with consummation assumptions,
No.
Yeah, that's inspired.
we'll go to the next one. This one is
Okay.
about Isaiah Stewart and Drew Eubanks, right?
Yeah, I remember this. I can do
Okay.
this one.
Next.
Both Stewart and Eubanks were going chest to chest before a swing to Eubanks' face connected on Wednesday. Sources said both were separated and there's police presence involved with the situation in Phoenix tonight.
That was a tweet, and then the second one was, I think, what Shams wrote in his actual article about it. I'll let you read it.
According to those sources, both Stewart and Eubanks were going chest to chest before a swing to Eubanks' lip area connected.
They were both going chest to chest.
This was a that's a Shams tendency, because he did that with like Draymond Green and Jordan Poole too, right?
Yeah, it was like
He
dispute.
is yeah, I think he did, yeah.
There was like at least
Yeah.
one other NBA
Chest
fight
to
where
chest.
he loved chest to chest.
It's like he because he is like sort of nominally a sports writer, he kind of has to like describe things as they exist in the world. And his
That's
attempt to do
usually
that
when
is
he
so
gets
funny.
into a pickle, yeah, when he
Yeah.
has to describe things in the physical world.
Unlike a swing to Eubanks' lip area, he doesn't really quite connect there.
That
One other
is
thing, one other thing I like about the first sentence is that the placement of the day of the week, it makes it seem like they were chest to chest for days. And the swing connected on Wednesday.
it's like a word problem about trains leaving Cleveland or whatever, where it's like finally connected on Wednesday.
His fist was moving at this speed.
That's beautiful.
It is standard police report
I don't
language.
remember if we blogged this, but does anyone remember why it was edited out of the story, or like what aside from being
I
terribly
think it was just like
written?
lip area was so stupid that even the editor was like,
Yeah,
we gotta change this. I mean,
I'm
if you want, I can click and see what it got
curious what the
changed to.
current text is.
Okay.
Lip area is so good.
Let's see. Oh, it's not even.
Oh,
Okay,
they took
we'll
it out
read from the.
completely. Yeah.
It just says, oh, okay. It says Isaiah Stewart punched him in the
Punched.
face.
Wow. Wow.
Okay.
He's learned to use. Oh, look at these ads also. Look at the
Yeah, like I'm That's because I edited Ross Jaguar's hat blog, so I was like clicking on all the links. Okay, so this is that's pretty clear. Then this part is just police statement, police statement. Expected to receive footage, statement from the Pistons, a statement from
Okay.
the Suns. So it must have been this part that was.
I think it comes right after this part.
Okay, William said he talked to Stuart. They just really just took the whole thing out, I
Yeah, they
guess.
removed the description completely.
They're just like, all right, fuck it. We'll just say he got punched in the face in the first paragraph, and then we don't have to deal with this
That's kind of a
anymore.
disservice to those of us who wanted to hear about the ch how long they were chest to chest.
Yeah. Oh, that was an
right.
excellent. The next one? The next one's
Yeah.
really good. I just
Yeah,
saw
yeah. You should do the
it.
next
You
one
should read this
somewhere.
one.
That incident caused a breach in trust, a source familiar with the dynamic said, which continued as the president's top protectors worked to avoid a second dog. The context for this is Commander Joe
Right.
Biden's dog biting people, for people who are unfamiliar. What does the headline say? Oh yeah, he bit him at least 24 incidents.
Avoid a second dog.
See
Avoid
if
a
it's.
second. That's so good.
I want to see if it's still in here.
Are they talking about avoid a second dog being bitten? Is
No, a
this a photo
second.
they
No,
made black and white to make it more grave?
I think that guy's just wearing a shirt devoid of color.
Wait, I like this sentence too. The recent dog bites have challenged us to adjust something, something, something.
Okay, wait, yeah, I'll go back. Sorry.
Oh, wait, no, avoid a second dog is still there. That's good.
Yeah, okay, we've confirmed that right here.
The recent dog bites have challenged us to adjust our operational tactics when Commander is present. Please give lots of room. The agents must be creative to ensure our own professional safety. It is like a prompt that you get for like the last area of a tutorial in a video game where it's like, okay, commanders, you have to get creative and figure out how
Yeah,
to
right.
LA commander.
For a stealth
Yeah.
game, like a Metal Gear game.
I'm just reading this now to see if there are any other good ones.
They've been heartbroken over this. They've
Good job.
apologized to those who have bitten and taken flowers to some.
Okay, I want to go to the second dog part just to see like the context for it. Let's see, second dog. Okay. Oh, so it was, yeah, they didn't want them to get a second dog, huh?
Work to
Okay, they
avoid a
want them
second
to
aqu acquire a second dog.
apparently Commander was a second dog because Major was the first one who bit an agent. And so so the top protectors did not avoid a second dog. In fact, the second dog is the basis of this article.
I
Anyway,
like
yeah.
how it's sort of like in the cadence of like second shooter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or like the I'm not gonna. I don't remember. But the George Bush photo of him being informed was
Oh God, yeah.
connected pretty easily to this. Anyway, we'll go to the next one.
I can do
Oh,
this one.
this is a good one.
Baxter is sort of a different kind of language you'd be using the rest of these guys.
Yeah.
The Warriors have long known the shift would come, but for years the team has struggled to establish a clear path forward to stave off the descent into irrelevance that has befallen other NBA teams facing the sunset of a dynasty. Part of that struggle, team sources said, has been their own success, the 2022 championship serving as a seismic event. This is great, because the great thing about metaphors is you can just mix as many as you want, and
Just throw
it
them
just
all in
makes a
there.
sentence more complex.
He has at least like three concepts from a Jerry Bruckheimer movie in this paragraph. We got the seismic event, descent into irrelevance,
Sunset of a dynasty.
sunset of a dynasty. There's
Okay,
too
so
much going on.
the first bit of figurative language. They're struggling to establish a clear path forward.
Okay,
That
yeah.
to me
So
is
the
like they're
path.
like in the jungle and there's like a lot of they have a machete and it's like hard
Yeah.
to make a trail.
Yeah.
And they the clear path forward to stave off if they don't do that, it will
They're gonna fall
descend into
down.
irrelevance.
They're gonna.
And a familiar relevance because other NBA teams have been befallen by that. The sunset of a dynasty.
Yeah,
Okay.
facing sunset.
Interesting. But there's also earthquakes here.
Well, the earthquake started the championship somehow.
Oh, they
Or the
got, yeah,
earthquake
the
was a
earthquake jolted
championship.
them here. Yeah.
Yeah, the earthquake jolted them into the jungle where they're trying to find the clear path forward so that they don't descend.
Also, the 20, like, part of the struggle has been their own success. Stop the sentence there. You don't need to have a championship serving as a seismic event that just like throws the
Yeah.
balance way off.
A championship is like a big event on its own. You don't need to describe it as something big. Well, that's a good one. Good job, Baxter.
Yeah, good job, Baxter.
Oh, this is a good one too. Ramona Shelburne. Do you want to read this or should I read this?
it.
Yeah.
Okay. Not counting the not so secret tunnels inside of crypto.com arena, there were at most 100 feet between the cozy interview room in which Denver Nuggets center Nikola Jokic was explaining how long it takes to build a championship team Thursday night after his team took a commanding 3-0 series lead over the Los Angeles Lakers in their first round playoff series, and the makeshift cavernous room in which LA's LeBron James and Anthony Davis were trying to reckon with how quickly their championship hopes were fading. I genuinely, when I put this in, I hadn't realized there was only one period of this sentence.
it's incredible.
So that is one sentence.
Architecture exists.
Oh man.
Yeah, can you believe these guys were in the same building?
The
Yeah.
part that would piss off Albert Bernico, I know, is took a commanding 3-0 series lead. Because the 3-0 series lead by nature is just is commanding.
Yeah.
Don't need to describe it.
This is again like the perfect Shamsi sentence because no information is being conveyed here. Like you said, Giddy, it's like some guys they were in the same building. But it's like what she is communicating is that like I know how things work. Like I
Yeah.
was there, like you guys don't understand what it's really like down there. It's like kind of a scene report, but not like there's no accurate vibes are being communicated here.
It is to yeah, it is to justify why she was at the game,
Yeah.
basically. Because
Yeah,
she didn't
there were a
like,
hundred feet.
yeah.
There were I mean, it also intimates secret tunnels existing inside crypto.com arena, which like kind of makes me want to know more about that. But
Yeah.
instead we just hear that these guys were 100 feet apart at most.
She should have written about the secret tunnels instead. But
Yeah.
also, I don't think it's like a. I'm trying to figure out if it's a complete sentence. I guess it is because it says there were. If the complete sentence would be condensed, there were 100 feet between the cozy interview room in which Nikola Jokic was in and the one where LeBron and Anthony Davis were. But the thing is, everything after Anthony Davis makes it seem like it's trying to start a completely different thought, basically. And then it just cuts off.
Yeah, I mean, just reading the sentence, it's very confusing because it's not immediately clear, like what she's trying to accomplish by setting it up. Like you just think it's going to be a sentence about Jokic and then all of a sudden these other guys come in.
Yeah.
But even if we grant her like that this is like an interesting thing to set up in the first place, I don't know that I would have assumed that these guys are like way more than 100 feet apart at any time in the evening
Yeah.
of like the basketball
If they're at
court
a
is
game, yeah.
94 feet. Like it's I don't know. It's not like such a striking number to me, I guess.
Yeah. It's a specific detail that really doesn't need to be that specific.
Yeah.
Well, all right.
Baffling sentence. Respect.
Next one.
I
Oh, this
got
is a
this.
good, yeah,
I
this is a
got
good
this one.
one. Please do.
That is why Warner Bros. Discovery CEO David Zaslav's diss track from 2022 is underpinning the sudden jump ball between Zaslav's TNT Sports and NBC for the last NBA TV rights deal that is still up for grabs. 2 years ago, Zaslav dunked on NBA Commissioner Adam Silver's league.
Just terrible.
So fucking
That
bad. sentence is just
So
boiled ass.
unbelievably bad.
His diss track is underpinning the jump ball. The jump ball that is
Still
the
up for
deal that is
grabs.
still up for grabs.
You don't need
Crazy.
up for grabs because a jump ball is
It's
by
already a jump
definition.
ball,
What
yeah.
does underpinning a jump ball mean, also?
Yeah,
I guess
that makes no sense.
is that the ref who throws the ball up, or
is
is
this like the
that
force of
no, the
gravity?
diss track is yeah, throwing them.
Oh, the diss track is underpinning. Okay, so the diss track is like maybe this sort of makes sense in like a cosmic sense, like if you assume the diss track is like the force of gravity, in the sense like the jump ball goes up, but then like that's what makes it matter. So, and like if you think in an extremely like Einsteinian quantum way, like this kind of makes sense. So respect to Marshawn.
I think this is Andrew Marchand's New York Post tendencies of always having like snappy puns or references to whatever the nature of the story is about. It's just like gone wrong because he's talking about obviously NBA TV rights. So he's like, oh, I gotta work in sudden jump ball there. And then
Wait,
right after he's gotta talk about
sudden is a really good adjective here too.
yeah.
Yeah.
A jump ball again is sudden and up for grabs.
And
But
then
then
he
also he has
like,
to bring in the dunk.
yeah, the dunk doesn't make any sense here either.
Yeah. Anyway, it's I mean I can
Yeah, the athletic. What's going on over there?
I wanna see something here. Go
Maybe
to
it's still
Divi.
in there.
Wait, what's the headline again?
Oh, it's still there.
Okay. All right. I thought it was kind of a fuck around and find out play at
Oh,
first,
okay,
but
so
fuck
yeah,
find
this
out.
was like the second paragraph of the story.
T
It has
yeah.
seemingly been part of the game since Dr. Naismith. That seemingly is really Yeah.
funny there.
Can you source for that claim? The Zaslav's words zinged the ears of silver NBA executives. It has left Zaslav and TNT Sports fighting for their NBA lives with a Faustian choice. That classic phrase we know, Faustian choice.
Can we go to the kicker
Oh my
here? Because
God.
I have a
The
sense
what?
that the kicker, can we see how it ended
Okay.
this? Because I have a sense it's going to be something really stupid.
Something really bad. Okay, yeah, that's a good
I
point.
see the word Lazarus here, but I think that's a guy's
Interesting.
name.
Oh, you were so right.
Yeah, let's go.
It's like the most co coherent metaphor too of the whole thing.
So far, yeah.
Zaslav talked trash, but Silver has the ball, and the commissioner may decide who he wants to take the final shot.
Okay. So
Oh my
wait,
God.
who is the jump ball? The jump ball is okay. This
Let's
actually,
go back to the jump ball.
the jump
There's
ball
some
was
consistency here.
the jump ball was between TNT and NBC,
Yeah.
and it was underpinned by the Zaslav diss track.
Yeah.
But
And the
now
jump ball is representing the NBA TV rights.
they're on the same team, TNT and NBC, and Silver is a point guard on the basketball court of ideas.
Yeah, trying to decide who gets the last shot. Yeah, that's true.
The English language is so beautiful.
I'm just like looking for like
Guy's
any
so
other
cool.
little metaphors that I can spot. Because Faustian choice is really good too. Okay. I mean that's all that's basically I think that's three butchered metaphors there. I think
Yeah.
we get the point. Not to pick on him, but also that is
Faustian
truly ass.
choice.
Yeah, Faustian choice is so good.
Oh, fuck. This one's great.
This one is about
Gotta be Caitlin
Caitlin
Clark,
Clark,
right?
right? Yeah,
Yeah. I
it's
could
like a
do this.
round table. Okay.
The magnifying glass on her is enormous, but the actual performances examined through the prism of reality have been the overall positive mixed bag almost any top rookie has early on in a pro sports career.
So there's a few objects here. We've got the magnifying glass,
The prism of
and then there's
reality
a prism of reality.
and the mixed bag.
Mixed bag, which is overall positive.
Yeah. Actually, I think magnifying glass and prism is like kind of coherent because a magnifying
Yeah.
glass
They're
is a
both kind
prism.
of, yeah.
But like
Yeah.
you have to be very delicate. Like every other word has to be very normal to make that
Yeah.
sentence like not get
And
wobbly.
then you're describing a mixed bag as overall positive, which is impossible because it's a mixed bag.
Overall
Can't
positive.
be overall positive. It
Well,
could
it's
be some
mixed, but
positive,
like the
some
positives
negative.
are sort of at the top. Like
Yeah.
they're overall. It's
It's like
actually as
not homogenized, is what you're saying.
yeah. Exactly. It's not a blended bag.
It's a raw, a bag of raw materials, basically.
Yeah.
But it is
Hey,
pretty good to
this is
imagine
decent.
a big. I just want to know how big the mixed bag is in comparison to the magnifying glass. Because if the magnifying glass is enormous,
It's
that
also like,
bag has got to be pretty big.
what the hell is journalism for except to examine through the prism of reality? Like, if you have to say that you're doing that, maybe you should like reconsider
Yeah.
the rest of stuff you wrote before that.
That's a really good point. Yeah. Unless
Yeah.
it's I we could click it in context. Maybe it he's
That
trying to
works.
contrast it with like empty slander of her or something,
Yeah.
but
I think this is the context here might be that this was when Caitlin Clark was still kind of struggling and the like Fever were pretty struggling. Oh, it
Just
was like
four
they're
games. Wait, first
four
sentence,
games
the
in.
product has been a mixed bag.
Wow. Can't argue with that. Okay, I'll find the, because it was the thing where there's a round table of ESPN writers, and each of them had to answer. This was where Vopel answered that. How would you rate Clark's performance through four games? So basically, it was not trying to say that she was terrible, but instead not really
It's been an
providing.
overall mixed bag. I feel like we gotta stop using mixed bag just as a metaphor generally, if it's not very descriptive.
Yeah, we
It's
need
like
a new bag of
what
some
sort of
kind.
bags are you dealing with?
Okay,
Okay, we'll go to the next one. This
Right.
that was
Perfect.
another Dan Hurley one, I think.
This situation is great because like the clear skullduggery and like agents lying to people to get pressure out there, like this is like Shams and Woj's Christmas. Like there's so much bullshit. All right.
Yeah,
This is from the King.
definitely.
Even though the Lakers moved quickly to offer Hurley a contract that would have made him one of the highest paid coaches in the league, several people inside the Lakers organization and externally wondered about the true overall genuineness of the pursuit and whether the franchise had been used by Hurley to get more money to stay at Connecticut. The Hurley situation was seen by one source with direct involvement in the search as a Hail Mary attempt. This is great.
I love true overall genuineness. That's a great,
Yeah,
that is like a George W. Bush administration era phrase.
also like inside the Lakers and externally. It's like
Yeah.
you see why
Everybody.
it's like hard to lean on adverbs. You see why.
I feel like true overall genuineness is like a mid-aughts, really
Yeah.
earnest indie band
Yeah,
album title.
the pains of being pure at heart's like fourth record.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is good. The Hail Mary attempt sort
That's
of
a classic
caught, yeah.
device. But
Also, I like, well, I guess what I was gonna say is I like that the Hurley situation is the thing that's seen as a Hail Mary attempt. It's like not the hire, the pursuit of him. It's just the situation.
again, that could be like a Robert Ludlum novel title, The Hurley Situation.
Hurley.
Okay, well, the next one.
Oh, we should pull up your f image for this afterwards
Oh,
too.
okay, yeah. I'll pull up the image once we read it.
All right, you do this one, Giddy or Sam or whoever.
Yeah, Giddy, you can do it if you want.
Anthony Slater, The Athletic. It's been a layered 5-year path to this divorce, splintering last season, sprouting earlier, and finalizing in the last couple weeks, where among the conversations Thompson had, league sources said, was a request of Stephen Curry not to exert his significant organizational influence and up the temperature with management to ensure Thompson's return.
Wow, actually have the photo right here or
that's
the
beautiful.
illustration.
The
So for
divorce graphic is great.
people who don't check Defector every day, this one was bad enough where I tried to draw it out. So that's what you got.
The Clay Thompson is inspired.
Yeah, there's like a little Clay Thompson right
It's
there.
so
But yeah,
good.
it's like a path to divorce, splintering and sprouting.
Imagine your marriage is failing and you go out with your friends and they're like, what happened? And you're like, it's been a layered 5-year path to this divorce,
Yeah.
splintering last season, sprouting earlier, and finalizing in the last couple weeks. They'd be like, damn, that's
I
crazy. What?
like a seven layer dip to this divorce.
I had to ask my kid not to exert his significant organizational influence and up the
This is a real contender for me.
Yeah,
Yeah.
it's one of the best ones.
Again, The Athletic. Do not, please, for the sake of this bit in this stream, do not hire any editors.
Yeah, do not
If you're watching
please.
this, the New York Times, do not hire any editors for them.
Maintain your current staff.
Yeah.
Okay, next one. Why isn't it clicking? Oh,
This
that was the
it?
last one. Okay,
Oh,
so we
nice.
gotta
Oh,
go
we got to
back
go
to
back. Oh, yeah.
Josina. Okay. There's a, just seeing this one. This is an incredible one.
We should add a little color here, which is that like she came out very strong with like the Vrabel, and then she had some late 2024 ones, I think, that we haven't read. But
Yeah,
then,
she had like some Ben Johnson stuff that we just
yeah,
kind of cut because we had so much Ben Johnson
we
stuff.
had some late 2023, late December after we already gave her the award.
But then like she was pretty quiet for a long time because the NFL season wasn't going. But then Area 1067 asks, should NY Jets fans be worried? A great question. Very simple answer, right? No. I've heard opinions, not concern, due to presiding depth and the closeness of that existing unit. That said, added talent is just that, added talent. In general, in situations like these middle ground, wait, sorry, in situations like these middle ground slash compromise is the objective. Yet for all athletes, acclimation periods are important to practice and game intensity. On the other hand, so is having financial security at a commensurate value.
This one is about Hassan Reddick holding out from the Jets. So the person's asking, should Jets fans be worried about his holdout? And basically what she's saying is financial security is important. And I'm not sure what else she's saying. I really can't parse it.
Well, in situations like these middle ground,
Yeah.
there's a
Basically,
missing
should
comma,
the
right?
in situations like these, middle
comma.
ground compromises the objective.
Yeah. So it's like
I've
an NFL team should sign a player, basically, is the sentiment.
Well, see, Tamar, that said, added talent is just that. Added talent is just that added talent.
It's amazing how there's both, someone pointed out there's both too many and not enough commas in these sentences.
Yeah, she's really playing with the form.
What I think is incredible too. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
I was just gonna say, the idea of quote having financial security at a commensurate value is sort of like miss like you're basically you're starting it from like the player's perspective, having financial security, and that commensurate value is like from the owner's perspective, but there's no
Yeah.
distinguishing of that. It's just like blah, blah, blah.
It's striving for true objectivity. I was gonna say what was interesting to me is with the like when Noah Lyles had his race this past weekend, I think Justina like tweeted something about it. And what was astonishing to me was how informed and like clear it was. I was like, oh, holy shit, like I'm gaining true insight from Justina Anderson like
Yeah,
explaining
that was amazing.
how the finish line works. And then it's just something about when she gets into the realm of NFL that's just impossible for her to come up
It
with
was
a
actually,
straightforward sentence.
yeah, I kind of opened the Noah Lyles tweet. It was like one of these you have to like click it to expand,
Yeah.
expecting it to be like equally impossible to parse. And then it was like so like clear and detailed. I was like, okay, she had to have run track at a high level. And then it turned out that she did. It's like, oh,
Yeah.
that's really cool. Like she's a great journalist when people ask her to write about like objective reality where events are occurring. But like whenever she's trying to describe whatever the hell is going on here, this is what you end up
Yeah, when she deals
with.
in certainty, it's like it's great.
The
Yeah, what was I forget now. I think it was the Caitlin Clark one, but like once she establishes that truth that like we're dealing in truth or whatever, then it's like we're good. You know,
Yeah.
as long as the subjectivity is taken out of it.
Well, the other, I just want to go back to the first sentence. So the person is asking, should fans be worried? What she's saying in response is that she's heard opinions, not concern. She doesn't describe the opinions in any other way. And she also doesn't say who has those opinions.
Yeah,
She's just
right.
saying she's heard opinions.
She couches why the opinions are not concerned. It's like,
Yeah.
and
They're not concerned because there's depth.
opinions plural, concern singular.
Yeah.
Presiding is really good too.
Oh. Yeah, this is
Yeah.
a really good one.
This is
What's the
pretty.
context of added talent here? Did they just like sign or trade
Well,
for
it's
some
just
other?
that added talent.
It's just, I think it is just like they have enough, they made some moves in the offseason or whatever and have enough front seven players that Reddick
Okay.
holding out won't hamper them as much.
I see.
But I don't know.
The committee has a lot to consider here.
Good thing we have this really long tweet to help us understand what
Yeah.
the situation
Okay, well that was the last one that we had for this this roundup. I don't know, are there any closing thoughts or I'm
I
just
think
gonna
I realize this is the first election year we've done this, and
Yeah, we're gonna get a lot of garbage over the
we're gonna
next
get
few
a
months.
lot of good shit.
Yeah, we're gonna get some really good stuff. I just wanna see that again, frowned expression.
He is not moving.
He is sitting slack.
This is kind of, it's like this, the second one is almost phrased in like the his ass is not reading.
Yeah, I think Lay put it on the site in that cadence.
Wait, this happened when we were all together, right? We ended
This
in.
happened literally
Yeah, it
like as
did.
the main meeting for that day
That
concluded.
was so
They're like,
funny.
it was like five of us in the room, and then they was like, "Oh, the verdict's in."
His ass is sitting slack.
Okay,
His ass has a frowned
well.
expression on his face.
Well, that's all we got for this time. Thank you
Yeah, thanks for
for
joining us. If you're still here, you're a
yeah, if you're
sicko.
still here. Also, if you see any of these in the wild, please send them to tips@defector.com. We will put them on the list. I think we'll do a year-end roundup like at some point in December, obviously. But
Yeah.
yeah.
Do we do the roundup before we hand out the award?
I think it's the same.
To like build hype.
Yeah, we might do another stream
I was
like
gonna
the week
hold out
before.
possibility of a like election specific one, maybe in like
Oh,
late October. So
that could be good. Yeah.
all of our
That's a good
readers
idea.
should be looking out for those and trying to send us, because with that there's just too much to keep track of, obviously.
Yeah, we'll do. Well, yeah, that'd be good. A standalone one would be good in
Yeah,
October.
good idea. All right.
Okay. Well, thank you for joining us and have a good day.